This video will briefly explain this snap-on wiper model and custom G-code. Bambu A1 and A1 Mini have a purging device, which is basically only used for purging, but lacks a wiper function. You will notice a notch on the purging blade that is about 2 millimeters lower than the nozzle. Many users don't quite understand why it is designed this way. Many designers try to create models in which the purging blade is more or less raised to wipe the nozzle. But these concepts are wrong. Let me explain the notches on the blade. It is located 2 millimeters below the nozzle, providing a good gap for oozing. You heard that right, it means the filament leak out from nozzle when go right to the cutting pusher and left to the purging blade. Now you might be able to figure out what went wrong with those designers who tried to lift the purging blade. Without the 2 millimeter gap, ooze will accumulate on the right side of the purging blade and eventually work its way back onto the printed object. So my solution is keeping the purging blade in its original shape, with the 2 millimeter notch and 90 degree left curve top, and add a snap-on my wiper module that would hold a specially cut V-shaped PTFE Teflon wiper. You may ask, it's basically the same design as the others, and will also capture ooze on the right side of the PTFE wiper. Maybe you're smart enough to figure it out from the video. Let me explain. Eliminating oozing during filament cutting is not simple. Custom G-code needs to be injected into Bambu Studio. The idea is to quickly extrude a few millimeters of filament over the purging area and then retract it. The fan speed is full when traveling to the cutting pusher and then back to the purging area. By using this custom G-code, the nozzle is very clean. The G-code is located in the model description and maker world. The URL can be found in the video description. And I'll show you how to add this custom G-code to Bambu Studio later in this video. Let me further explain the G-code for motion in the video. The filament change procedure begins, move to purging area, rapidly extrude 5 millimeters, then retract 25 millimeters. Fan full speed, rush to the cut pusher, then end of custom G-code. Again, you see that the nozzle comes back very clean, with barely any visible ooze. Retraction in the custom G-code can be adjusted from a minimum of negative 25 to a maximum of negative 35. The retraction length is limited by the heat break length of approximately 20 millimeters and the hot end nozzle length of approximately 25 millimeters. You can adjust this value by monitoring the cut. This value should follow the length of the heat break since the filament inside the heat break is still cold. The more you retract, the more you save when changing the filament. Let's take a look at the test results of two color printing on two cubes. By using this wiper module and custom G-code, we may no longer need Prime Tower for multicolor printing. Let me show you how to inject custom G-code to get the best experience with this snap-on wiper. Here we have custom G-code for A1 and A1 Mini. Make sure you're copying the correct model type. A1 and A1 Mini use different G-code sets. So the difference is the purging area and cut pusher location. In Bambu Studio, go to the printer settings, machine G-code, change filament G-code. We only need to modify the change filament G-code part. Always follow the setup instructions and use the latest G-code on the model page. Save it by append, wiper, or whatever makes sense to you. Now your wiper and custom G-code are all ready. Would be nice to test with two multicolor cubes, or print the wipers in multicolor again. You can try printing it without the prime tower. As long as the wiper is in good shape and at the correct height, you can get good prints by using this custom G-code with extra retraction to save some filament and deactivate the prime tower. Unfortunately, we are not able to use custom G-code on the Bambu Handycap on mobile phones. In this case, it only takes 10 seconds to remove the wiper at any time, even during printing. Finally, thank you for watching. The video explanation ends here. From now on, it's two cubes and two colors, and the print time is 20 minutes.